Good evening. It is Tuesday, November 12th, midnight. This vlog is all about Disney Plus, which officially launched a few hours ago. If you haven't seen the video on my YouTube channel, I entered the Disney Plus Dream Job Contest, which was held by reviews.org. They were picking 5 people to watch 30 Disney movies in 30 days and receive $1,000. I worked really, really, really hard on my video and I didn't get picked. But instead of giving up, I decided that I was going to do a 30-day marathon on Disney Plus anyways, even if I'm not receiving a check. So here we are. I'm going to be blogging about it, vlogging about it, and updating social media. I have a really bad migraine, so we're going to start off very easy. I have on my Felix Gray glasses to help me look at a computer screen for a little bit longer before bed. I think instead of a movie tonight, I'm actually just going to watch a series. Some of the things on my list aren't actually in Disney Plus yet. So we're going to go to the first thing on my list that is on Disney Plus. Which is, well, it was on here. So let's search. O-N-K-E-R-F. There it is.
Has anyone ever figured out why Bonkers D. Bobcat looks like Chester Cheetah? One is a bobcat, one is a cheetah, and I know it mostly has to do with coloring, but why does he look like Chester Cheetah? I don't know. He just does. I'm not the only one who sees that, right?
Sometimes some crime goes slipping through the cracks of these two dumb shoes.
Standard procedure, of course. Oh, one more thing. Don't breathe within 10 feet of me. Okay.
Don't worry, boss. I'll be okay in 3 days. It's just a little case of dude flu.
It is 12:49 p.m. I am still working on blog posts, trying to get ahead on work. I've officially watched 3 episodes of both Bonkers and Chip and Dale Rescue Rangers, so I'm going to dive into another show, a childhood favorite.
Sweeps out of the shadows, darkening of the night. Somewhere some villain schemes, but his numbers up to Darkwing Duck.
It is now 3 o'clock and I am still working on Christmas blog posts. I finished 3 episodes of Darkwing Duck, so I need something new to watch. And I think it's time for my first movie. I was going to start with my favorite Disney movie of all time, Tarzan, but it is sadly not available. So I have to move to my second favorite Disney movie of all time.
I come from a land, from a faraway place, where the caravan camels roam.
I'm already tearing up because in the beginning of the movie, Aladdin has to steal food to eat, and he's about to eat his piece of bread that he stole, and then he sees two kids digging in the trash for food, and he gives them his only food.
Ten thousand years
will give you such a crack in the neck.
I'm crying again.
In your camp. You got some punch. Y'all be round house. All you gotta do is rub that lamp.
And I'll say,
Mr. Lambert, I'm your
maitre d'. What it is you want? You ain't never had a friend like me. You look like a... Well, look at here.
No friends,
abracadabra.
Am I gonna stop crying at any point during this movie? I'm actually really struggling.
To be my own master, such a thing would be greater than all the magic and all the treasures in all the world.
Genie, I'm gonna miss you.
Me too, Al.
No matter what anybody says, you'll always be a prince to me.
By something, from this day forth, the princess shall marry whoever she deems worthy.
I took a short break to watch some YouTube and eat some fruit. I had a pear and a plum. Now it is 5:45. Before I start my next movie, I'm actually going to watch the TV series first. I've been doing 3 episodes of each TV show with room for more if I have time. That's the plan for the next little bit. I will be here blogging, and now I will show you what I'm watching.
Hercules, who's Danny's a great creator? Hercules, is it bone? Is it sweet? My favorite flavor. Unhand those underthings, Vandal!
I don't see anything alike.
Slay me if you must, but leave this quality lingerie alone.
Icarus, what are you doing?
I'm doing my duty as an intern by completing my assignment and protecting my temporary workspace. Plus, I get to touch all the frilly things, though.
Call me crazy, but like, that was allowed on Disney Channel when we were young?
Look, I'm sure my son has a good explanation for all.
I am still working on the computer. It's taking a little longer than I thought, so I'm going to go ahead and start my next movie. First comes Tarzan, then comes Aladdin. The final movie in my top 3 favorite Disney movies of all time is Hercules.
Long ago, in the faraway land of ancient Greece, there was a golden age of powerful gods and extraordinary heroes.
We'll take it from here, darling.
You go, girl.
We are the muses, goddesses of the arts, and proclaimers of heroes.
Heroes like Hercules, honey, you mean Hercules.
But then along came Zeus, he hurled his thunderbolts. That's the gospel truth.
His name is Pegasus, and he's all
I want one. It is 11:30. I actually wanted to get to bed at 11, but it's so much going on today. Working on the computer, everything just took longer than I thought. Wanted to give you some final thoughts for the day. I ended up watching 4 TV shows, 12 episodes total, 3 for each, and then 2 movies. So, Bonkers, Chip and Dale's Rescue Rangers, Darkwing Duck, Aladdin, Hercules, the animated series, and Hercules. I basically relived my childhood, which was amazing. I know a lot of people went back and forth between Disney Plus originals and older stuff. I am interested in some of the originals, but Disney Plus for me is watching old shows that I haven't seen since I was a kid, shows that I haven't had access to. That's the whole point for me. The originals are just extras that I can watch at any time. a lot of people had problems today because it's a new streaming service, so there's going to be some bugs. I didn't have as many problems as other people, only the occasional loading issue where I just see the circle, or some of the controls would freak out from time to time on my iPad. Like if I wanted to go back to a part in an episode or movie, the little slider wouldn't work. I'd actually have to shut down the app, reopen it, and go back to that episode. I actually wasn't in a very good mood all day, but I did thoroughly enjoy my first day experiencing Disney Plus, and this is only the beginning, so I will see you tomorrow for day two. It is 9:30 a.m. I was up 30 minutes ago. I'm about to turn on some Christmas music and hop in the shower real quick, and then it will be back to Disney Plus.
It's Christmas again and everybody's home.
It is 11 a.m., which means it is time for a late breakfast and some DuckTales.
Life is like a hurricane.
In DuckBird.
Race cars, lasers, aeroplanes.
It's the DuckBird. Real quick, I just wanted to show you a little Easter egg in this episode. Magica uses Bibbidi Bobbidi Boo on Mrs. Beakley. I wanted to show you another Easter egg that's not Disney related. Magica's raven, Poe, who is actually her brother, who was turned into a raven, is based on Edgar Allan Poe.
Wait! Let go of my nephew, Magica, and give me back my dame. I'm warning you now! I'm warning you evermore! Ah!
If I'm not mistaken, he says both evermore and nevermore. From The Raven by Edgar Allan Poe.
Oh, don't do that. It only upsets her.
Sorry. Just like all the other shows, I was only supposed to watch 3 episodes of DuckTales. Oops. I watched 4, and am now on episode 5. I need to move on to my next show, which is a little newer, but still very fun, and technically my childhood.
He's on his way to the throne, he's on his way to success, but he has to go to school.
He's gonna ace that test.
He's an emperor to be, and he's totally.
You know, it's all about me.
Wait. What do you girls see in that guy? I mean, I'm just as handsome as he is. If I had his chin and his chest and his muscles and his
deep voice.
Hey, you forgot his cute dimples.
It is 12:40. I'm headed off to work very soon, but I'm bringing my iPad in the car because I have to wait while my dad's at a doctor's appointment. Maybe. We're not sure yet, but I'm bringing it just in case so I can keep watching Emperor's New School. It is 7:34. I just got done eating dinner. I finished my 3rd episode of Emperor's New School, so I started Goof Troop. I should be able to fly through 3 episodes of that while I'm working on the computer. And then I need to pick a movie for the night while I'm in the bath because I desperately need a warm bath. Especially because I need a good night's sleep tonight because I have to get up early and film a video. So that's what I'm doing for the next hour or two.
Get the ball back to the captain.
The travels that time. They're actually fun to watch because they, you know, it's the youthful hunger and sharing the ball. And everybody loves an underdog. What's the thing you come on? Come on,
might be a worse looking dude out there than Dudley.
And the defense
Captain Caruso is locking down Jordan Poole. Oh, here we go. Good pass, good pass.
The offense.
It's 12:50 a.m. Definitely didn't want to go to bed this late, but all my blog stuff took a lot longer than I thought it would. I have a few things to update you on. Number one, earlier when I thought I had accidentally watched 4 episodes of DuckTales instead of 3, no, some of the episodes are missing in the lineup for whatever reason, so the episode numbers threw me off. I had actually only watched 2 episodes. So after I finished Emperor's New Groove, I watched a 3rd episode of DuckTales while I was in the bath. I have a list of TV shows I want to watch, and they are in alphabetical order. I went from Emperor's New School to Goof Troop. The next show was supposed to be Even Stevens, but I didn't look at my list beforehand, and for some reason, Even Stevens wasn't on my watch list, so I went to Goof Troop immediately because I looked at all of the first letters and I didn't see another E, so I moved on to G. That was my bad, but it's not that big a deal. I'm just gonna watch Even Stevens tomorrow. I really enjoyed everything I watched today. DuckTales was amazing, and Emperor's New School? I forgot how much I liked that show. I feel like that's a gem from Disney Channel that people don't really talk about. Also, Emperor's New Groove. I never really watch that movie or think about it, and yet every time I see it, I really, really enjoy it. I don't know, I feel like it's moving up in my rankings. Also, I feel like we don't talk about the friendship between Kuzco and Pacha enough. Pacha is just like the sweetest character. He's so great. I ended the day with 12 TV episodes and 1 movie, so we are now headed into day 3. I was gonna wake up early and film a video, but no, that's not happening, so I'm just gonna sleep for as long as my body sleeps, and then I'll be up and back to work. It is 8:30 a.m. I didn't really want to get up this early because I'm so tired, but I guess it's better for productivity. Gonna get some breakfast and then start my first show for the day.
And you know that it's the best of both worlds.
Moisturizer. You're pretty funny. Oh, my hand does feel softer.
Corbin Blue in the first episode of Hannah Montana. That's just smart marketing, honestly. Just good taste.
I miss you. I miss your smile. And I still shed a tear. Every once in a while.
I'm tearing up at Hannah Montana.
Cool. Good place trying to figure things out.
It is 12:20 and I've already made it through 3 episodes of Even Stevens and 3 episodes of Hannah Montana. I think I'm actually going to take a break from shows and turn on a movie.
Because you know, they do not ring all by themselves.
They don't?
No, you silly boy. Up there, high in the dark bell tower, lives the mysterious bell ringer. Who is this creature?
Who?
What is he?
What?
How did he come to be there?
How?
Hush.
So, I never noticed what Phoebus says in this scene. It's super subtle, but funny.
Come on, boy. Achilles, heal.
Get it? Achilles, his horse, heal. Achilles, heal.
You think he's ugly now? Watch this. Well, that's ugly.
You recognize that voice? It's Patrick from SpongeBob.
God help the outcasts, hungry from birth. Show them the mercy they don't find on earth.
I'm going to pause real quick from Hunchback to show you something really cool. I am subscribed to Christy Carlson Romano's YouTube channel. She was in Even Stevens as Ren Stevens. She was also the voice of Kim Possible. She started doing a show on her channel called Throwback Kitchen, where she has child actors come on the show and usually make things from the movie or show that they were on. And look what today's video is. Cheese jerky with Jason Earls from Hannah Montana. How perfect is that?
I'm the man who had the cheese.
I'm the man who had the jerky.
We put them both together.
And yeah, they really working.
Cheese jerky.
Say what?
Say what?
Cheese jerky.
Say what?
Say what? Mozzarella mousse, Swiss, and Magouda turkey.
Just one taste, it'll drive you buzzer.
Cheese jerky. Say what? Say what?
Cheese jerky.
Say what? Say what? It's all frickin' 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 fresh.
Sizzlin' Stewart and Smokin' Open Enterprises, patent pending.
I got distracted and took a couple of breaks from Hunchback. So it is now 2:40 and I'm going to move on to the next show on my list.
Do you see what I see? It's a cloud in the shape of a rabbit. Cute. No, lower. A rabbit in the shape of a cloud, even cuter.
Higher.
Nick with a goofy smile on his face. Nick with a goofy smile on his face?
It's a planet, a showman. Everybody's in the group. Live to party!
In the very first episode of Jonas, Nick crushes hard on someone, finds out she has a boyfriend, and then has a really hard time moving on. I mean, how relatable is that? Who says Disney Channel can't be deep? I also have to say, Kevin Jonas really shined on this show. I know that the big debate has always been Joe versus Nick, but the reason is because all of us love Kevin. If you say you don't like Kevin, you're lying to yourself.
Why am I tearing up during Jonas?
I can't wait to see what you guys ruin next year.
Basically, the brothers accidentally destroyed their old home movies, and their mom was really upset, so they recreated them. And it made her cry, which in turn made me cry. So, cool.
It is 4 o'clock. Next show.
Rufus has gone missing.
Maybe he's hibernating.
Not likely, Kim. It's Spirit Week. If the little guy missed it, he'd be crushed.
Rufus!
Oh, hey, hey.
Rufus!
Your face is average, girl, and I'm here to save the world. You can't stop me because I'm Kim Possible.
And listen up, the police are going to give us a lift home. Lock and load!
That voice is Patrick Warburton, who also voiced Kronk from The Emperor's New Groove. In a surprising turn of events, it is only 6:15 and I am already on to my last show slash movie for the day. I'm ending the day with a movie that is in my top 10 of all time. It is so good, and personally, I think it is underrated.
Spoiler alert. and Ian Dunahy's brother Sidka dies within the first 15 minutes. By now you know that my favorite Disney movie is Tarzan. There is a connection between Tarzan and Brother Bear, and one of the biggest reasons that Brother Bear is in my top 10. Here's why. That is Phil Collins. Basically, he can do no wrong.
Thanks, Sitka. If it weren't for you, I would have never met Kenai.
I always wanted a brother.
Phil Collins is singing, and Kenai's telling Coda his mom is dead. Oh, his little boy. Why did I not remember that this movie makes me sob? I honestly didn't expect this. I'm honestly a mess right now. Oh god, the music's making it worse.
Trust me, I'll be there watching over you. Just take a look.
It's 11 o'clock and I am headed off to bed. I actually got called in to work tomorrow morning instead of tomorrow night. Today was a great day. I was surprisingly emotional for more than half of the things I watched on Disney Plus, which I wasn't expecting, but I really enjoyed obviously watching the shows I used to watch in childhood, teenhood, but going back and watching Hunchback and Brother Bear was very special. Those are two of my favorite Disney movies of all time. Brother Bear, wow. We don't talk about that movie enough. It is a gem. It is so emotional. I love it so much. I actually have a very, very, very special plan for tomorrow, so I will see you in the morning to reveal what I have planned. It is 8:20, and I am declaring today Lizzie McGuire Day.
Know what you're thinking.
Hope you're getting one step closer each and every day, and I'll figure it out on the way.
It is 9:15 and I'm headed off to work. I got through 2 episodes of Lizzie McGuire. I don't know if I can watch any in the car because of Wi-Fi, but I'll try. Otherwise, I will check in with you when I get home this afternoon and we will rejoin Lizzie McGuire Day.
Don't ruin the surprise. I guess all I'm trying to say, honey, is that I know we talk a lot. I talk a lot, okay, about the changes that you're going through. But just try to remember that the only thing I want is the only thing I've ever wanted, and that's just for you to be happy. Okay?
Obviously, by now, we all know Paolo is an awful person. We've all seen this movie a billion times. He doesn't fool any of us anymore. But only now am I realizing how lame his attempt is at making Lizzie believe that he's this singer-songwriter that music just flows out of. Listen to this.
For me, it's no problem. I write the music. I don't know where it comes from. It just comes from me. La 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 la, see? So I can go solo.
What? That was so lame. The first time that I ever watched this, how did I not see through him? He literally goes, la 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 la, you see? Music just flows out of me. Like, What? Freaky, freaky. Huh? Way freaky. Way freaky.
Same to Mikhail.
This is my
dream. Oh, no.
The burning question on everyone's mind is, will Gordo make an appearance on the new Lizzie McGuire show? And will they end up together? Or will they part as friends? Also, will we ever see Miranda again? We deserve to see the trio one last time. Before I say goodnight, I have some things to discuss with you about Lizzie McGuire. Number one, I remembered every single lyric to the theme song. Absolutely nailed it. Number two, wow, is Lizzie dramatic? No wonder this is my favorite show. Clumsy and dramatic. Those are my two middle names. Number three, I totally forgot about this cameo. Let's see if you recognize this child actor.
Hello? Okay. It's been really, really, really cool being your class president, and I'm really, really, really bummed that my term is over.
If you didn't guess, that was Sarah Paxton. She was a replacement actress in the Halloween Town movies. She was also in Aquamarine, which is not Disney, but it was a favorite of teen girls in the 2000s. So I'm scrolling through these, and I thought I watched 10 episodes of Lizzie McGuire. Nope. I watched 11. That is it for day 4 of my Disney Plus marathon. Even though I had to work, I think I still got in a good number of episodes and a movie. I declared it Lizzie McGuire Day, so I basically lived my best life today. I don't know exactly what I'm going to do tomorrow because I work again in the morning, but I have somewhat of a plan that you'll just have to stick around and find out. What could it be? What could it be? I swear I'm actually about to go to bed, but all of a sudden I'm starting to feel nauseous, so I grabbed some ginger ale. Kind of scared because my brother just started feeling sick, and now I'm not feeling well. Just concerned because I have to get up early and work in the morning. I can't get sick. Too many things to do this month and next month. It is 3:47 and I am exhausted. I was up at 7 a.m., got ready for work, had a very busy shift at work. I was filling orders like a mad woman. And then I was looking for pumpkin spiced apple cider for a video with my mom after work. We went to Sprouts, Trader Joe's, Albertsons, Ralph's, 4 different stores, and that doesn't include a failed Amazon order to get this product. Nothing. I don't understand. Like, I didn't think it would be this hard. Is it that popular that it's sold out? I did find sparkling pumpkin spice apple cider at Sprouts, so I bought that as a backup plan. I just don't know if it's normal to have sparkling cider hot because I'm looking for a drink to be warmed up. I don't know. I'm just extremely tired and ready to relax, eat dinner, and watch something on Disney Plus. I've got too much. I have too much going on. Thank God I have my iced eggnog latte from Starbucks. Today is going to be another chill day. I'm only planning on watching 2 movies, and they go together. Not as sequels, but they're themed after the same thing. Let's see if you can guess what it is before I show you.
Hi, my name is Caitlin Kingsford, but my friends call me Dork. Well, they're not exactly friends. They're the competition.
Fall.
And I'm the girl to beat.
All these years later, and I finally know what Caitlin means when she says this.
That's it!
The final buzzer sounds of a
Tanya. Uh-oh, she's a Tanya.
If you didn't hear it, she said, uh-oh, she's a Tanya. As in Tanya Harding. Wow. Now that the movie's over, can we talk about how amazing this soundtrack is? Seriously, take a listen. First up, Superchick.
Hey,
Next up is Everlife. My second and final movie for the day is actually recommended right under Go Figure. Another favorite Disney song by the one, the only, Ally and AJ.
I love Mr. Bast. If he uncovered a scholarship I didn't know about, he's a genius. And to think they pay him almost nothing. I mean, the devaluation of teachers in our society, it blows my mind.
Mom.
I'm back. Sorry.
I don't know why, but Joan Cusack makes me laugh so hard in that scene.
What a shocker. I'm crying.
I don't think I've seen anyone come back this far from mid-program disaster since Majora Ito in the 92 Olympics.
How can I not see? You see me better than anybody.
Have I ever cried during this movie? I don't know if I've ever cried. Guess there's a first for everything.
We'll need to find something healthier. How about, you know, grape nuts?
Grape nuts?
Yes. What about cod liver oil?
Guys.
You know what? I am her mother. What I say goes. She is my daughter.
She is my skater.
Well, daughter trumps skater. Ask anyone.
It's 11 o'clock and I am headed off to bed because I have to get up early for work again tomorrow. Even though it was a long and stressful day, I really, really enjoyed coming home, eating, relaxing, and watching Go Figure and Ice Princess, two of my favorites that both have to do with ice skating. I love them so much. The soundtracks are amazing. Can't wait to get home tomorrow and watch some more Disney Plus. I already have a plan in mind, so you'll just have to stay tuned to find out what it is. Good night.